So let me ask you a simple question.
No, you haven't answered our first question, my friend. We're not here to jump over your hoops.
We asked you a simple question.
Is it rational for God to claim that the sperm comes from the backbone and the rib? That's the first question. You answer that, and then we answer you.
If you have listened to my answer the first time, the Quran doesn't say that.
It says, speak it in English.
My friends, listen. What I have recited are the ayat of the Quran which talks about the very subject that you are claiming in your misunderstanding.
Surah At-Tariq, which I have just recited
in Arabic.
No, we don't believe that because we don't understand Arabic. So now, another one.
Sing it.
Yeah, tell me what it says.
No, you sing.
Now, you establish your claim.
He was created from a fluid injected, emerging from the backbone, between the backbone and the ribs. Is this a rational thing for God to say?
Slow down. Is that rational or not?
If it is rational, explain to us why.
Slow down.
Understand Arabic.
Don't go.
Understand Arabic.
It's an Islamic word.
Yeah, he created fluid injected from the backbone.
Okay, are you listening?
Because this is.
Quran makes here two statements. Let man think from which he is created from.
No, of course not.
Statement number one.
How many? Are you judging according to this person? If I tell you story right. in French.
Let's pause there before we go to the next statement. What is that fluid?
We can't get to that. I'll get to this later.
It doesn't refer to sperm.
You're saying this is some word. It doesn't refer to sperm.
What?
Even on the Quran saying it doesn't refer to
sperm.
Listen carefully, my friend, and you will understand and learn. Right? You'll have a proper education today, God willing, if you want to.
This is not an education for someone who wants to learn.
So, this gushing fluid is something that is called ma'in dafiq. It has in the grammatical construct of the one who is doing it himself. The fluid and the contents is propelled by itself. So the sperm within the fluid, we know, is self-propelling.
That's the most illogical crap I've ever heard.
Yes.
Are you not hearing this? You're saying that sperm propels out of the backbone.
I hear no word about backbone.
Do you not know how
women don't have sperm,
my friend? Why does it say backbone?
It says backbone and bone.
The first statement, I said there's two statements to look into it. The first statement talks about the gushing, self-emitting fluid.
What's that fluid? I'm explaining. In scientific words, I am explaining, right?
The reproductive fluid. Right? Which is constituted with the secretions of prostate gland, pupus glands, semen vesicles. Is it all fine?
Well, things in the backbone.
The first statement has nothing to do with backbone.
No, it says that in the Quran.
It says that it emits from the backbone and the rib.
So essentially, Allah claims that women have sperm, that it means from the ribs.
Deal with that.
All of the scholars say from the backbone.
Yeah, they all say from the ribs.
Which scholar you want?
Issue from the loins, Arbery. Shakir says coming from the ribs. Yeah. Sarwar says,
which comes out of the loins and ribs.
Sorry. And Khalifa
says, are you not able to have a conversation?
So all your scholars,
stop shaking and listen.
1 minute. All your translators are saying that it comes from the backbone. So how are you going to tell me that sperm comes from the backbone?
Listen and understand.
No, how is that not irrational?
I know, how is that not irrational?
I haven't even gone to my second statement.
Work on your rationality.
You said about rational, yeah.
Try to understand that I made one statement, right? I just read one statement. First statement is to do with the gushing fluid and its characteristics. The second statement says where it comes from, and that's what you are dealing with. But I want to deal with the first statement first.
Now, is that rational, first of all, before you move?
First statement.
Is that rational, yes or no, before we move on to your next point?
If you were to listen, you will learn that.
No, I'm not learning nothing from
only,
you, my friend. All you're doing is
speed up. Not only the first
statement. All you're doing is speed up, innovation. Like, this means this, this means that. Your scholars disagree with you. It says, Yusuf Ali, proceeding between the backbone and the ribs, right? Pick four, that issue from between the loins and the ribs.
Tell me when you finish.
It just goes. So, my question is, do you think it's rational for God to claim that the sperm comes from the backbone and the ribs?
Okay.
Yes or no? If it's yes, please explain to us why.
Now, I am answering, right? Without, I expect you to listen to my answer, right?
Listen.
I am saying the crucial verses are two verses, right? I gave you verse number one, and there's a verse number two that will come. The verse number two, that is what you're dealing with. But I need to start with the verse number one, which is about the very characteristics of the reproductive fluid. It is saying, why do you jump to the second verse, leaving the first one? Hello, Sako, listen. If you were with any comprehension skills,
you don't have none.
You would realize.
Get to the point where you explain why your body thinks that the testy fluid comes out of the backbone.
Okay.
Get to that point.
Firstly, allow me to go.
Why is that rational?
How does sperm come from the backbone, bro?
Yeah.
Kunchi or Quran? Let's get to that.
Are you going
to
just keep on repeating the question?
Is that rational? How is that rational, please?
Listen. Now, so the first point.
We're not
sincere. We're going to expose them. Just here.
Brother,
out of these two statements, the first statement says something astonishing scientifically, which is, it talks about within this fluid, something this fluid is self-emitting. If it was the normal Arabic construct, hear me out first, it would have said madfuk, but it doesn't say madfuk, it says dafi. That's why it is something that the scientists are baffled. How did someone 1400 years know that this is try to understand. Proceeding from in between the collarbone and
what's even worse for you?
Collarbone, it says loins and ribs, loins, breastbones, back and ribs.
All your scholars
are calling you a liar.
I thought
you had the decency to let people speak and explain themselves.
Listen. Yeah, you are doing beta.
I have read more than 40 translations on this.
Have you?
Yes.
Oh, good.
Thank you very much. Now listen then. The word Tara'ib in Arabic.
If you want to know the meaning, why would you go to find the meaning of an Arabic word?
Arabic dictionary.
In an Arabic dictionary.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
If you want to consult...
Arabic speakers.
Let me finish.
Answer the question.
I am.
Okay, so now, how is that rational?
If you want to consult...
Literal Arabic scholars, by the way.
Subhanallah, listen.
Arabic scholars.
Listen.
So much.
If you want to consult the Arabic dictionaries, which are authoritative and acceptable by all, like Qamus al-Muhit, As-Siha, Mukhtar al-Siha, Kitab al-Ayn, Lisan al-Arab, Taj al-Arus. Are you listening?
Backbone and ribs. Backbone and ribs. How is that rational? Answer that to me. How is that rational for God to claim that the sperm comes from the backbone and the rib?
You, of your ignorance.
You said Christianity doesn't make any rational sense. If my question to you is the following.
I was explaining it to you. Just
how is rational for God Almighty to claim that the sperm comes from the backbone and the rib? Explain to us. Why is rational?
We don't want your tafsirs, bro. We want what the Quran says.
What the Quran says.
The tafsirs are useless. The tafsirs do not work. What the Quran says, bro.
So listen now.
Last chance.
You can go away, but I'm speaking to him.
Last chance.
I am asking you a simple question now. The verb which says proceeding from, what does it refer to? Does it refer to the sperm or the gushing fluid?
That creates. The fluid that creates life. Creates life.
I haven't finished.
No.
I haven't finished my question.
The fluid you're talking about,
are you
trying to make a distinction between sperm and say water or all the fluid? The fluid that creates life, that particular fluid, comes from the backbone and the rib. We are asking, how does that make rationality? How is that rational?
Did he not ask, how does the sperm coming from the breast and the backbone rational?
Yes.
So did I understand your question?
Please answer.
No, did I understand your question?
How is that rational for God to claim that the sperm... I want to ask you again, and then I'll give you the floor to explain it, yes?
Listen.
How is that rational for God to claim that the sperm comes from the backbone and the rib, please? How is that rational?
I understood your question? Speak. Have I understood your question?
You have to repeat again. You have to repeat again.
I want you to answer.
Your brothers are watching. You're waiting for the answer, bro.
Yeah, they are.
Not me,
because
bro.
I want you to listen for the answer. So I'm repeating once more. Have I understood your question?
Have you understood my question? I don't think so, because I have to repeat about 5 times.
Okay. You are asking me, how is it rational for God to say that the sperm comes from the breast and the backbone?
Backbone and the rib. Yes, that's my question. How is that rational, please?
I understood your question?
Yeah. Explain to us.
Thank you very much. Don't repeat the question again, because I've already understood your question.
If I have to, I will.
Don't be a child.
I'm not your demi. This is not Sharia corner.
So now, when it says proceeding from, in between the backbone and the ribs, my question to you is, does this refer to the gushing fluid, or does it refer to the human being mentioned a verse earlier? To help you understand what I'm saying, it's your turn to now comprehend.
So what human being comes from the backbone?
Listen.
Yeah. What?
Look, it says...
What fluid that creates life? Because the context of that particular verse is the fluid that actually creates life.
You're making a difference into your own.
Do we agree with that, first of all? That the fluid that the Quran is mentioning is the actual fluid that creates life. Do you agree with that, yes or no?
There is two arguments here in the Quran, not one.
Do you agree with
that? So this is an education for you now.
So you don't agree with that?
In the Quran...
You haven't even showed us anything. You proved nothing.
Nothing.
Carefully then. Verse number one talks about the characteristics of the gushing fluid and what it does. Yes, it creates human beings. Correct. Verse following talks about another argument.
That emanates from. Now, correct?
If you allow me to
explain.
No, I'm explaining you, listen. Because I've understood your question.
Where does that now, come from?
The second statement, I am saying it refers to the human being, not to the gushing fluid.
That wasn't mentioned at all.
That wasn't mentioned. That's a lie. He's lying to you guys.
That's a lie you just made.
He's lying to you guys.
He's doing tequila again.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says it's sperm. Listen, the actual sperm comes from the back of the ring.
Listen, once we finish this, we are going to return to the question of rationality of your belief over all other religions and
religions. Your belief has already been proven to be irrational.
Now hear me out. Now, verses later, it says, إِنَّهُ عَلَىٰ رَجْعِهِ لَقَادِرٍ. God surely is able to bring him back to life. Jazakallahu khairan, be patient. One verse, one person, one voice, right? Just let me be your representative. I know what I'm doing. I've debunked those people a long time ago. You can do it again.
Now
here, it says he will bring back again. God is able to bring him back to life, right?
Move to a different verse. Now.
Listen. This
verse, bro.
These verses has nouns and pronouns and a verb with a hidden noun. When I said
hidden noun.
So it's not clear. The Quran is not clear.
Verb says yahruju. Do you know what it is?
Sorry? What is it?
What it's something about Wahuju, bro.
What's that Wahuju?
He doesn't speak Arabic. Bro, do I speak Arabic?
I'm going to give you some lesson now for you to understand. Because you're dealing with the Arabic Quran, not the translation.
Bro, the translation are all from Arabic people. So I'm just throwing them in the bus and saying, oh, listen. Wahuju.
So now what we have here.
Get to the question.
Yahruju is a verb.
Yahruju
is a verb.
That's what you call it.
Which says, proceeding from. Within this verb, it has what we call Damir Mustafa. It means there is a pronoun already embedded within this verse. Like when I say,
hidden pronoun.
I'm going to give you some grammar lessons now, right?
Crouching hidden pronoun. So Allah hides things in the Quran.
No,
and he sends people like
language,
him to explain.
In language.
So Allah sends people like him to explain the verse.
In language, when you say, the door is open.
Yeah, he needs to explain the verse to me because Allah can't explain it to me. When I read the book, I can't work it out. You need to explain
Okay.
When we say the door is opened, within that verb opened, is there someone opening?
Stick to the verse, 86:7.
I have to teach you.
How does that make rational sense, Mansoor? How does your God say that the sperm comes from the backbone and the rib? How does that make rational sense? Answer that.
And comprehension.
It's about your God. You can't comprehend anything from me because
so
I need you to explain it.
Yeah.
It needs you to explain his own words. It's kind of stupid, isn't it?
No, it's for you to listen. I am saying the verb here refers to the man. The man, it is not referring to the gushing fluid. If you were to ask any Christian Arab, they will say, Yakhruju can, this verb, refer to a noun that is mentioned immediately or even a little bit before that. Go and bring your Christian experts who know Arabic.
I need the cocaine.
And get some education from them.
Well, they will just agree, like Christian Pitts agrees, that the sperm literally comes from the backbone. That's what your God says to the women. You still haven't explained
Christian
that.
Prince the liar.
If you believe he's a liar, it doesn't matter.
No, no, no.
He's Arabic.
Do you think he's a liar?
Do I think he's... No, I wouldn't think he's a liar at all.
Have you seen the 101 lies or more lies about his lies on the internet? On Farid...
Is that a Muslim YouTuber?
Listen, what does it mean? Muslims are dishonest?
What it means is that YouTuber has a voice to protect his Quran.
And if it was a Christian YouTuber, it's not going to have a voice.
By any means, like make up good information like your hadith said.
Why don't you go and listen to what this channel has exposed these lies of Christian Prince. Be a man enough to listen to us.
Why don't you watch David Wood? Watch David Wood, watch Sam Shamoon. They've both exposed Islam 1,000 times.
Sir, oh yes, you wish, you wish. Now, again here.
Okay.
So here, okay, these verses talk about the human being, they are emanating, look, the human, during birth. Do you know where the baby comes out from? In between the ribs and the backbone. This is where baby comes from.
It doesn't say anything about a baby.
Okay.
It talks about, let man think where he's coming from. Man. Okay. It refers to man.
Let JC respond anyway.
One last point, and then I think I'll leave the room.
So basically, before I move on to you, as you have realized, grammatically, contextually, I have given you an explanation and some free Arabic lessons to you, demonstrating that the Quran here not only has no scientific errors, not only has any irrational statement in there, but it's actually pretty amazing when it talks about the self-propelling nature of this fluid.
Thank you, Masoor. Now let me come back. Does anybody know who Ibn Abbas is?
Look, this is the Arabic
translation. Do you know who Ibn Abbas? Ibn Abbas. Who was Ibn Abbas? For your brothers who doesn't know.
Carry on.
Who was Ibn Abbas?
Carry on.
Ibn Abbas was considered one of the greatest scholars. If I'm not mistaken, he's the first cousin of the Prophet Muhammad. The first cousin of the Prophet Muhammad, yes? Thank you. This is what he says about Surah 86:7. He says this, that issued from between the loins of a man, the sperm, and ribs of a woman. So Surah 86:7 is referring to that women has sperm that emanates from the ribs. That's his commentary.
Game over.
Finito. You're going against Ibn Abbas, the greatest scholar that your Prophet Muhammad was the greatest scholar. So, wait. So here's my question. Based on what I read, that the gushing fluid comes from the ribs of the woman, according to Ibn Abbas, how is that not irrational?
Scholars, they can have opinions themselves.
Oh, they could just have an opinion.
Listen carefully. This is not what the Prophet said. This is not what the Quran said. Brother, one second.
Quran says,
the Quran said, and I have contextually.
I have the Arabic.
Subhanallah, brothers. Excuse me, brother, please. I have shown you.
How many days?
Linguistically.
40 days. The baby stays 40 days as well.
Are you listening now?
The other one.
I have shown you. Contextually, linguistically, the Quran does not say what you claim to say. There may be commentators, there may be scholars mentioning this, but this is not what the Quran says. Because people can...
Translators have... Literally, all your translators agree that it's the backbone. We've shown you that it's seminal fluid. Now, you're going to have to show us where your interpretation comes from. Yes, it doesn't come from the Quran, and it doesn't come from the
test. We'll show you evidence. Show us evidence.
If you are listening at all,
we'll be listening for the past 20 minutes.
I have said, contextually and linguistically. If you don't know what this means, let me tell you what this means. From the language itself and from the context itself, it refers to a human being, the man that is referred to in the first verse, فَلْيَنْظُرُ الْإِنسَانُ مِمَّ خُلَقَ. It talks about man, which I have just shown you here. Yep. So what does it come from?
Man is made.
Have we finished?
Yes, don't forget about that.
So
Where
is the man created from?
Gushing fluid.
I said two statements. Man is created from a gushing fluid. Statement number one. Statement number two, man emerges from between the backbone and the ribs.
Doesn't say that. It says the seminal fluid comes from the backbone.
It means from the backbone.
Read the Arabic for me.
Don't hide behind the Arabic.
Hiding behind Arabic.
We got the translation.
We're hiding behind the Arabic. It's the Quran that is Arabic.
Ibn Abbas says
only. He's Muslim and he agrees with what I'm saying.
Ibn Abbas is the first cousin of the Prophet Muhammad.
That you hate your God, you hate their books, so you might as well not be a Muslim.
There are many people.
Come up with a different tafsir.
are many people within the Christian tradition, Muslim tradition, Jewish tradition, they have said things which you say it is only a reflection of the knowledge of their time. Now, let me ask you, do you believe Christianity is rational?
Mate, you're going to have to answer them.
I've answered already.
No, you haven't answered
yet. I don't.
Is it rational for your God to say that seminal fluid comes from the backbone?
I explained to you, and you have a block in your years understanding.
Bro, you haven't asked the question.
Look, nothing. If you have a comprehension problem,
we've showed you the translators, you still now, have not come up with a good argument for why seminal fluid comes out of the backbone.
If I give you a translation which agrees with me, you'll accept it, right?
Well, the greatest scholar. So he's going against the greatest scholar.
He's going against every scholar. He's going against every scholar for one scholar that agrees with him.
I'm making the greatest scholar.
Don't do that to me.
I'm going to give you a translation which agrees with me. Would you accept it?
It says here.
If I give you a translation on this verse, it agrees with me. Would you accept it?
Would you have a translation disagree with
me? I'm asking you the question now.
I'm saying if the majority disagrees with
you. It's not majority, it's about the Arabic. So I have given you the Arabic.
Let me read it. Don't run.
Be sincere and reflect on it later. Is Christianity rational?
So what we're reading about?
Why? Because you're not just Semen stage,
the last 40 days.
The Semen stage, okay, 40 days.
Hudhayfa B. Usaid reported directly from Allah's Messenger, peace be upon him, that Lai said when the drop of semen remains in the womb for 40 or 50 days or 40 nights, the angel comes and says, my Lord, will he be good or evil? And both. These things should be would be written down. Then the angel says, my Lord, would he be a male or a female? And both these things are written, and his deeds and actions and his death, his livelihood, these are also recorded. Then his document of destiny is rolled, and there is no addition to and subtraction from it. Muslim 23.
It's not only Allah, even Muhammad failed one-to-one biology.
It's Christianity rational.
Muhammad also.
So Muhammad and your God.
Okay.
Basic Bible biology. God and his prophet.
I thought you're able to maintain a conversation. I'm asking you now, is Christianity rational?
I'm asking you like, from these statements.
I have already explained the Quran.
You've proven that Islam is not rational. Because God being the creator of all things, cannot honestly come down here and say, oh, seven fruit comes from the backbone, by the way. It doesn't work like that.
So basically, you are selective in hearing, right?
No, you are selective in hearing.
No, your translators are selective in hearing. Everybody else, the Quran is selective in hearing as well. Cool.
Allah failed to communicate basics in the Quran.
Let me ask you again.
Allah failed to communicate.
That's why they sent Mansur to
All the translators
who are Arabic, who are Muslim, disagree with you. So you bring in a translation.
And Muhammad disagrees with you
as well.
Listen carefully.
He's shamed of you.
So now, you have just demonstrated that not only you're insincere, because I said...
I don't know where you got that from. You're insincere. You haven't shown me any proof.
You said you would not accept the translation that I bring.
Bro, I'm waiting for proof.
Where is the sincerity?
I'm actually waiting for proof.
So now, let me ask you again. Is Christianity rational?
No, you haven't answered this.
According to God, seminal
fluid comes from the backbone.
I've explained it already.
You haven't. How is that not rational?
You can believe I haven't, but I have already.
You got to claim that a baby stays in 40 days. Sperm is from the testes and epididymis.
I'm quite surprised that these people have a selective hearing. I have explained already, linguistically, contextually.
But for some reason, they are deaf. You've gone against Muhammad, you've gone against Allah, you've gone against Ibn Abbas. all the translations.
Not only
he's supposed to be the creator of all creation.
So not only I have shown you that you have a lack of comprehension. Do you have comprehension?
Yeah, because you don't want to learn. You don't want to listen.
What does comprehension mean?
You're either going to give a good excuse to your words
lack of
any logic, or you're just going to talk about comprehension.
What does it mean? Do you know what it means?
Mansoor.
Do you know what it means?
Mansoor.
You lost the debate, Mansoor. I want you to convince us why this is rational.
We have debunked too many times.
You haven't.
I've debunked
you
today.
Haven't.
So bye bye now.
You haven't.
Can I just ask you about this? In your dreams, have selected
flow. Yes, I can.
Bro, ask this question.
So, let me ask you again.
Is it rational for your God to say?
Is there anyone here among the Christians, they believe Christianity is rational?
Yes, I do. Now, let's say
this is rational.
I said I do.
How is it rational for the sperm to come from the back of the rib, Mansoor?
I said I do.
I just said
come
yes.
on, Mansoor.
Right. It's more rational than
so tell me now. When you have got the Father one person,
God
the Son.
Alright, so you can see this is rational. So you can see that this is rational.
At least admit that it's rational for your God to say that seminal fluid comes from the back.
Admit
that first, then I'll talk to you about the truth.
I am not going to give you another debunking. You have been debunked already.
All you've shown is that your God is irrational.
So you're selective hearing again, right? So let me ask you again. God the Father, how many persons is it?
No, ask.
Bro, I'm waiting.
Answer to us.
How many persons is
God? How is he rushing on my food?
God the Father is one person.
How many persons is God the Son?
And so.
How many persons is God the Son?
God the Son is one person. God the Spirit is one person.
How many persons is the Holy Spirit?
Before you move on, ask if he concedes the point. The rationality
of the irrationality.
I have debunked your prayers. In your dream, live in your grand nightmare.
You have
to debunk.
All the translators, like even your own Quran, agree disagree.
Listen, I gave
that's
you.
That's all you learned during the lockdown.
Linguistically,
improve your walking
and
skills.
And you don't even have a clue what you're talking about. So now, how many persons is the Holy Spirit?
Bro, I'm not answering your question. You answer.
I want to you to demonstrate now.
I know why you have
Christianity.
You're running away from the fact that your God has
seven rushes to come from the back of the ring.
You can beat around the bush. It's already gone.
You're running away from your rational God.
Listen to the tape by rewinding it.
Your God debunks you.
Now,
your prophet debunks you.
How many persons?
Even Abbas debunks you.
And the
all your scholars debunked you, Mansoor.
Together, are they one person?
Don't answer that.
Are they one person, or do you add them?
What's your question?
I'm asking,
now,
why does Allah say there's seven...
We have done that already.
Is that rational?
These people have a selective hearing.
Is it rational?
They can rewind the tape
and listen. Is it rational to say that semen comes from the backbone?
Yeah, who thinks it's rational?
No one. Anybody with a brain for Allah apparently doesn't know that.
Let me ask you. Let me ask you.
Even though he has a brain for
Allah. How many person is the Father?
Okay, so you can see this. So you
can see this person is the Father.
So you can see this point.
I've educated you already.
Before we move on,
you have been debunked already on this.
To agree that your religion is the back on the roof. You can see that, yes?
Do you know? If you have been debunked,
You have not convinced anyone.
Because
you
sperm is from the testes, not the backbone. Remember that.
So now, let me ask the Christians again.
He needs to tell that to
how many persons?
Allah, tell your ghost that sperm comes from the testes, not the backbone.
There's no point repeating what's already been explained. You are not a child.
You
are already a grown-up individual. I said you're not a child. What do you think you're a child? You're not a child. You are a grown-up man. So now, I'm asking you a simple question.
I really want to answer your questions.
Is Christianity rational?
I did say yes.
What do you mean by rational?
Elaborate.
Right. That's what I was asking him.
Well, there's a double standard.
What do you understand by rational?
He doesn't want to answer whether Islam is irrational or not. But he wants to talk about Christianity.
That's why.
Then you can talk
about
Christianity.
We are now going to move on to the very question that we asked.
Okay.
How many person
is irrational.
If the God, do we add the person or do we say that's one person?
How is it irrational for Allah to claim that the sperm comes from the backbone
of the
rib?
Sperm come from
we
the
are still waiting
move
for
on.
Your answer,
you've been debunked. Move on.
No, you haven't. Have it. No one.
You don't like it? Doesn't matter.
I want you to tell me about the holes in the Quran.
Yeah, the holes in the Quran, please.
And also the holes.
There's holes in the standard. There's holes in the standard.
There are the holes in the standard.
My friend. My friend.
Maybe it is as good as the backbone.
Listen all carefully. Would you speak to someone who have no basic knowledge of what subject matter they're speaking to?
Sheikh Yasir Qadir, is that you? I know you have
if
no knowledge on
someone doesn't have the basic knowledge of the subject matter, would you speak to them? Exactly. I know.
The reason why. I don't want to hear your teachings.
We don't speak to this preacher.
I could care less about your translation. I care what your God says.
Listen.
I could care less about your translation.
The reason why we don't speak to this creature is because of following.
She
is.
Oh, you can't speak to me.
Is she not a creature of God?
Can you tell me?
She is a creature of God.
Holes in the narratives in the Quran.
Let me tell you.
Can you please tell me about the hole?
The reason why.
The only thing is following your stupid God.
She mocks and insults and ridicules.
That is Islam.
All the time.
Has been mocking
she lies and deceives. Not only that, she has no basic knowledge of the subject matter.
Power tactic.
Tell me about the hole.
Right.
Tell me about the hole.
I will make one exception for today.
Let's give him a question.
Now, I will make one exception today.
You are not going to make one exception.
The reason why I will only speak to her if she has the basic knowledge of the subject matter she's dealing with.
Let's put that in practice.
I want to establish this.
Let's put that in practice.
Do you know the difference between... Now, this is basic knowledge.
Let me hear this question.
Now, this is to establish the basic knowledge of the subject matter. Do you know the difference between Tashil of Hamza and Ishmam? Question number one. Question number two. Can you ask her to shut up and listen?
Question number two. Even your sheikhs are telling you there is serious problem in the Quran.
Keep on listening. I asked her a question.
Why are you so afraid
which
to talk about this?
Establishes someone have basic knowledge in the subject matter they're asking questions on, right? I asked her, and she's going to respond to saying, yes, I do know about you, I don't know. The question is, what is the difference between Ishmam and Tashil of Hamza? Question number one. Question number two. Basic knowledge on the specialist subject requires you know the terms and answers. So she's not known that already. Question number two, my friend. The difference between Qira'a and Turuq. Go ahead, answer these two questions.
So, for centuries, day after day, Islamic Dawah gangs, as well as early Muslims, stepped into the history and then tell us there is one perfect preserved Quran.
She hasn't got a clue.
She's worthless.
I'm not going to hear this question. She needs to demonstrate the basic knowledge of the subject matter. Let me ask you, do you know the difference? Do you know the difference? أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. Few things first. If you are wearing a mask, other people can't hear you unless you speak loud. So by the very virtue of wearing a mask, I have been in the need of shouting loudly so people can hear. But unfortunately, people who are watching, like this is a recording for you, those of you who are watching later, in the midst and comfort of your homes, because of the microphone, the voices carry much loudness and amplified to you, because it might be right next to me.
But the other people who are listening to what I'm speaking, they don't hear me much unless you shout. So those of you who complain and reason why I'm so loud and rude, private conversation. Get away.
This is speaker's call.
Get away from my conversation. Excuse me.
What private conversation?
1 meter distance and wear a mask, please. Wear a mask. Yes, wear a mask, please. Otherwise, move away. Move away. I don't want you here. Move away. So this is what.
Now you are using the coronavirus.
Excuse me.
To not answer the
question. Move away from my talk.
I find that's very, very amazing.
Move away.
But I seriously want to know about
right.
the call.
So,
according to Yasekade, it is messed up.
Excuse me.
Very, very much messed
hello,
up.
Hello, creature.
And they don't want to talk
excuse
about it.
Excuse me. Can you move away?
But
what you don't... These people have become heckless. Because no one listens to them. No one understands their rhetoric. That's why... Get away. So as I was explaining, I have to speak loudly. It doesn't mean I'm being rude. It doesn't mean I'm being arrogant. It is because I have to project the voice loudly, right? Point number one. The second point we were discussing here. Excuse me.
There are holes in the crowd.
So she wants a rematch.
Now,
do you know the basics of what you're talking about?
Very much loved home.
Do you know the basics of what you're talking about?
Akbar.
Do you know the basics of what you're talking about?
As you can see,
what's the difference?
Person,
I'm going to give you another chance.
So,
I'm going to give you another chance.
Read again.
What's the difference between qira'a and turuq?
What Yasir Qadri said.
What's the difference between qira'a and turuq?
The issue of the ahruf and the preservation.
Come here. See you later. Now, the second point I'm trying to make, I mean, if people are offended by the way I treat this creature, it's because she is vile, she is so much Islamophobic and hateful, she mocks and insults and ridicules our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If you watch their channels, your blood will boil. That's how they are. We have boycotted them. But I gave an opportunity today to see if you know anything about the subject. So what did I ask her? A simple question on the very subject matter, on the qira'at. Does she even know what these are? If she knew, she would have said, I know what this means. I asked her there, I asked her here, she would not respond. It's quite evident that these people haven't got a clue what they're talking about. So are you gonna take knowledge from them about this, what is it Yasir Qadri has said? These people don't even know how to speak English properly, let alone understand what Yasir Qadri has said, let alone the specialist subject of qira'at and ahruf and ulum al-Qur'an. So we abandon them in their misery because they do not want to sincerely want to learn. Okay? So that's what we established by demonstrating that they lack basic knowledge on a subject matter and yet they demand you explain to them. Coming to the third point, I was discussing with this gentleman over there, the Christian gentleman. Out of all religions that he knows of, the common ones, atheism is a religion, in my understanding, is a religion which is a lack of belief in any God. Christianity, Judaism, Islam, Buddhism, Hinduism, which one makes rational sense? He said Christianity. So that's why I want to ask him, how is Christianity in its belief, in its doctrine, rational? What you have seen and what we have demonstrated, they not only are afraid to talk about the rational basis of their faith, not only they're unable to demonstrate the rationality of their doctrines, but they're not even willing to understand their opposite person who's having a discussion with, the counterparts, the opponent, whoever they might be. They're not even willing to understand. So he brought up an ayah or two from the Quran, from Surah Al-Tariq, about how the sperm of the human being is created from the backbone and the ribs. And he thinks this is irrational. What I demonstrated, like I've done before, and you can watch those videos already uploaded, speaking to atheists, ex-Muslims, and people who have no faith, and so on, right? Demonstrating linguistically from the Arabic language, contextually from the surah itself, that this can refer to the human being, which emanates and proceeds from in between the backbone and the area of the ribs, which is this enclosure. During birth, this is where the baby comes from. Now, he's not willing to listen to that because he knows his game will be up, because that explanation is not only commonsensical, it makes sense, it's visual, and you can see that yourself, right? So there is no scientific error or a mistake or irrational case of the Quran talking about where the sperm comes from. Having refuted the claim and debunked that, I wanted to return back to the rationality of his doctrine and religion. He wasn't willing. None of them were willing. The only person who was willing was this creature of God. God has many creatures, right? Some of them are Khairul Bariya and some of them are Sharrul Bariya, the best of creation, and some of them the worst of creation. And Allah describes who are the best and who are the worst, right? She knows her place. I don't have to discuss that. You should see the creature of God. She wants to come and discuss about the subject matter without discussing the very topic that we want to discuss. We don't want to entertain them. So those of you who come to Speaker's Corner and are willing to come to Speaker's Corner, do not engage with these Islamophobes, with these bigots, with these people who insult your prophet day and night. That's their job, day and night. They insult and mock your religion, your prophet, your God, right? She's saying God is a mouse when you say Allahu Akbar. I mean, look at the insult. Would any Muslim say Jesus is a mouse? Would they? Never. Never would they say that. But these people have become so low. They become even worse than the animals. Worse than the animals. Even animals don't do this kind of behavior. Even animals don't behave like that. So, the simple message that I want to throw is, just because we avoid these creatures in the park, doesn't mean Muslims don't know how to respond to their criticisms. We've done that and debunked them already many times in the past. You only need to go to some of the channels where we've explained it. Sam Dawa, SC Dawa, EF Dawa. Let's unite upon Haq. What are the channels? If you listen to these channels, you will see that these criticisms have been already debunked and answered. So there is no newer reasons, again, to convey this, you know, criticism to them and say, look, this is the answer. It's already done and dusted, brothers and sisters. There is no point of saying, why don't we answer? We have answered it. Find us a new criticism that we haven't answered. Find us something that they have raised that the answer is not provided yet. Then you can have a meaning saying we are somehow confused. Yasir Qadi said something. Guess what? They haven't got a clue what he said. They haven't got a clue what he said. If they have a problem with the comprehension, did they bother asking Yasir Qadi? They didn't. Some Muslims did. And he explained his position. He clarified what he meant. If you show them the clarification, she won't take it. He won't take it. Why? Because in their heart it is disease. They don't want to believe what goes against their bigotry, what goes against their hatred, what goes against their wishes, that I wish Islam is proven to be false. They will try and they will fail. In the park, we have been coming here demonstrating the truth of Islam, the truth of the Quran. What have they done? Instead of showing Christianity is true, all they resort to is like, oh, Islam is this, Islam is that. Go and preach your own religion. Go and sell your religion if your religion is true. We don't have to talk about your religion. But you come and tell us God died, of course then we will question the very nature of this belief that God dies. God dies? God got beaten up? That is the reason we engage with the polemics of the Christians from their own sources. But we don't need to do that. Allah in the Quran has already explained the nature of their belief and already shown the errors of their ways. To those of you who would be callers to Islam, this is a message to you. Read the Quran. Learn the Quran. Learn the explanations from our pious predecessors and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam from his Sunnah. The answers are there. It is because you spend so much time in social media without learning your own deen, without learning the Quran, that you find yourself in this problem. That suddenly you have some doubts and confusion. Why? Because you have not spent time that is deserving of you to learn about your beautiful, about your glorious religion, about your just religion. Spend time learning it. Once you have learned, all these doubts and confusion, they will just drop and wither away without you doing anything, because you will see how weak and feeble these arguments are. Any Muslim here can demonstrate the weakness of their arguments, let alone a scholar who can give them a schooling. So Muslims, educate yourself firstly and foremost. Once you know your religion, then your faith will be stronger. The reason why you suddenly think I don't know what it is because you haven't learned your religion. Once you know that Allah is one and only, any belief which says God is 3 in 1, 5 in 20, automatically will make sense to you that this is irrational, unreasonable, nonsensical, unbelievable, unacceptable. You don't have to even go to the scripture to find out that this statement is there, because you know this is something that makes no sense whatsoever. So the danger of Muslim youth apparently getting confused, the danger is your own ignorance, self-inflicted. What would make you to learn about your religion? How much do you love Allah and His Messenger? If you really want to love Allah and His Messenger, know about Allah, know about His Messenger. And then you'll realize how it transforms you. How it transforms you into a person where it will withstand all those criticisms and shubuhat and doubts as they arise. This was the message I wanted to give to you. May Allah bless you, my brothers and sisters in Islam. May Allah give you the tawfiq, the ability to learn about this beautiful religion and become the message bearers, the ambassadors, to pass it on to someone who hasn't heard about Islam. أقول قولي هذا، أستغفر الله ولكم، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.